Hello students, welcome to physics laboratory. The name of the experiment is the figure of merit of the galvanometer. The aim of the experiment is to determine the figure of merit of the galvanometer, voltage sensitivity of the galvanometer, current required for half scale deflection and current required for full scale deflection of the galvanometer. The apparatus required for this experiment is 2 volt battery, 3 resistance boxes,
and they are named as P, Q, R.
Commutator, table galvanometer
and connecting wires.
Galvanometer is a device used to measure current in a circuit of the order of few microampere. It consists of a coil suspended between the poles of powerful magnet. As current passes through the coil in the galvanometer, the coil gets deflected and the pointer attached to the coil moves on the scale in the galvanometer. So, galvanometer deflection is proportional to the amount of current passing through it. This is the circuit diagram for finding the figure of merit of galvanometer. The current required for unit deflection in the galvanometer scale is known as figure of merit of the galvanometer. In this circuit diagram, a battery of EMF 2 volt is connected in series with two resistance boxes P and Q. Then the resistance box R is connected in parallel from Q through the commutator key. A table galvanometer is connected from other two terminals of the commutator key. This is the table to enter the observed readings. Arrange the components on the table and connect them as per circuit diagram. Connect positivity of the battery to P resistance box. And next terminal of the P resistance box is given to first terminal of the Q box, and next terminal of the Q box is given to negative of the battery. So this is the primary circuit. So we have to complete the primary circuit first, then go for the secondary one. Now connect Q resistance box to input terminal of the commutator key. Then next terminal of the commutator key is given to one of the terminal of the R box. Then next terminal of the R is given to Q, that is second terminal of the Q. Then two remaining terminals are there in the commutator key. The two output terminals are given to galvanometer. This is about the circuit connection. Next we discuss how to take readings using these components. Initially introduce 988 ohms in P box and introduce 12 ohms in Q box, 12 ohms in Q box, then keep 0 in R resistance box. Now switch on the battery. And keep commutator key in the normal direction. Note down the galvanometer deflection and it is noted as theta 1. Here theta 1 is 27. Next we have to find out galvanometer resistance by half deflection method. For that we have to introduce resistance in R box until the deflection becomes, that theta 1 becomes half of its value, that is half of 27 is 13.5. So now gradually increase the value in R box till it becomes 13.5, the deflection becomes 13.5. Yes, now the deflection is 13.5, the value introduced in the R box is 98 ohms. So this is noted as R1. So R1 is equal to 98 ohms. So immediately, the next step is immediately we have to keep zero resistance in R box. So keep zero in R box.
Now keep commutator knob in reverse side. So the deflection in the galvanometer is in opposite side. So the galvanometer deflection is noted as theta 2 here. Here theta 2 is 28.
Now gradually increase the resistance in resistance box R till the theta value becomes its half of its value. Here theta 2 is 28. The resistance given here is 96. For R2 is equal to 96, the theta becomes half of its value, that is 14. Keep zero resistance in resistance box R. The experiment is repeated by decreasing Q in steps of 2 ohms and increasing P by steps of 2 ohms so that P plus Q is equal to 1000 ohms. The observations are tabulated. In this demonstration class, initially we introduced 988 ohms in P box and 12 ohms in Q box. The galvanometer deflection in one direction is 27, theta 1 is 27 and its corresponding R1 value is 96. The galvanometer deflection in reverse direction, theta 2 is 28 and its R2 value is 98. Now find the average of theta 1 and theta 2, and it is 27.5, and the average of R1 and R2 is 97. The average value of R1 and R2 gives the galvanometer resistance G. So G is equal to 97. Then the value of Q by theta is calculated. 12 by 27.5 is 0.436. Continue the experiment with different combinations of P and Q such that P plus Q is equal to 1000. So increase resistance P in steps of 2 ohms and decrease the resistance in Q box in steps of 2 ohms. Then we find the average of G value and Q by theta value. You can arrange the question, why can't we go for the combination P is equal to 986 and Q is equal to 14 ohms. The galvanometer deflection theta increases with Q. In this combination, Q is equal to 12 ohms and the galvanometer deflection is around 28. If we increase Q value, the galvanometer deflection becomes out of scale, that is beyond 30 divisions. But we need the deflection should be within the scale, that is within the 30 divisions. That's why we repeat the experiment by increasing P in steps of 2 ohms and decreasing Q in steps of 2 ohms. Using this observation, we can find the figure of the merit of the galvanometer using this formula. Here E is the EMF of the battery and it is 2 volt. The resistance introduced in P and Q resistance box is 1000. The average value of galvanometer resistance G and the average value of Q by theta are noted from the table. After substitution, the value obtained here is the figure of merit of the galvanometer, that is nothing but what is the current required for unit deflection in the galvanometer scale. Given galvanometer has 30 divisions in the full scale and 15 divisions in the half scale. If you know the value of current required for unit deflection in the galvanometer scale, we can find the what is the current required for half scale deflection and what is the current required for full scale deflection. So this is the formula for finding the current required for half scale deflection. It is 15 into figure of merit of the galvanometer. And current required for full scale deflection is 30 multiplied by figure of merit of the galvanometer. The galvanometer resistance G multiplied by the figure of merit of the galvanometer gives voltage sensitivity of the galvanometer. Thank you.